Hello, this is Bronwyn Ailey, local food systems and small farms educator for University of Illinois Extension. And for this week's video update of local food happenings at DSAC, I want to focus on a couple of different things. The first one is going to be just an overview of the progress of crops being grown in our high tunnel with the permanent in-ground raised beds, in which we have the determinate tomato variety trial as well as the bell pepper spacing study. And as you can see over my shoulder, we have a few plots of various different types of cut flowers. And so we'll kind of look at the progress of our crops in this tunnel. And then the other thing we'll focus on is pruning and lowering of the cucumbers in the hydroponic tunnel. And my coworker Julie Zakes is actually going to be talking about how she lowers and prunes the cucumbers, and kind of the method that she has developed that goes pretty quickly and is pretty easy to do. And so that's what we plan to share with you this week. And hope everybody's had a good week and enjoyed the last few days with a relatively low humidity, although I know we've had quite a bit of sunshine. And I guess hope everybody's going to have a good weekend, and we'll talk to you next week. Thanks. So one of the topics we wanted to cover in our weekly video update was our pruning and lowering of our hydroponic cucumbers. And today we are going to have Julie Zakes, who works with me here at Dixon Springs, is going to talk about how she raises or how she lowers the cucumber vines and prunes as she goes. And so let's step back and let Julie tell us about pruning and retraining these cucumbers.
Okay, so these are some of our English cucumbers. They don't grow quite as fast as some of the other varieties, so we're not going to see a big drop. But one thing I've started doing, instead of actually lowering the spool every week, which involved a ladder and a lot more effort and a lot more clips, was actually lowering the plant on the clips, which I'm going to show you in 1 second here. And it really saves on all the string that we use and the number of clips. And I've also reduced and went down to just 2 clips per plant, which holds all of the weight perfectly, and there's no use in really using more clips or more clips going to the landfill or having to deal with them and take them off. So what I normally do, and sort of once you've done it a bunch, you can sort of gauge how many leaves that you would get rid of. I don't want any leaves touching the ground when I'm done. So I'm going to lower my plant first. Cucumbers are really easy. So I drop my clip. And forgiving and drop really well, especially when they've got some weight on them. Sometimes the tendrils will stick, but they're pretty easy. So my first clip back isn't really, it's not supporting anything whatsoever. It's guiding the plant on where it's gonna go. My next clip, I wanna secure, find a stout leaf that will secure it and hold the weight. This one doesn't have any fruit. It's all been picked, so it's pretty light. But you can see 2 clips do the job. And I've also just went through and trimmed my strings, and that way I don't have to tug string through tendrils at the bottom or get caught up in that. So the next I'm going to go, you can see we've got some fruit that didn't make it here. We had such a big, sometimes we get such a big fruit load on that the bigger ones or the smaller ones don't make it. I've got one little sucker here. And then again, I don't want any leaves touching the ground, especially when it comes to spraying and that. I want to make sure everything that I have to spray, I'm able to get to. Anything on the ground doesn't really work. And in hydroponics, we can only support maybe 4 to 5 feet of plant material also, so that's all that we want. We had some plants in years past get to be 40 feet long, and we just keep pruning them as we go and keep going. So that one didn't have too much on it. This next one, you can see it's got a little more fruit that isn't gonna make it. And while that's up and easy to prune, I'm gonna do that real quick. And sometimes it's easier to check for suckers before we lower it. I'm going to lower this. And I do pretty much the same thing with tomatoes. And I sort of came up with this because with tomatoes, if you leave extra clips on it and go to lower them, you'll actually snap your plant. So instead of having to move a bunch of clips, you can see two clips does it. I prune leaves. Try to get rid of any weeds or anything, if there's any down there, just because weeds can also harbor bugs too. So a lot of people don't think when you're spraying pesticides on your plant that there could be weeds down there and bugs also. You can see this plant's got a whole different ball game going. We haven't picked much off of it yet. So you can tell it's going to be really heavy. It's still just got two clips. I'm going to get rid of my suckers while they're easy. I think that's it. Undo my clips. And it's quite a bit of weight, but it's still pretty easy. It's still much easier to me than going up and using a ladder on every plant, much quicker. And they're pretty durable, you can see. And then since he's a little bit heavier, I'm going to go a little bit lower for my second clip to make sure I support that weight. And you can see two clips works out great still. As usual, whenever I try to do something, you know, really good, I usually fail. So basically I was in a hurry and didn't make sure that my string was securely fastened in my clip there, and it all just slid down. So now that it's securely fastened, I'm gonna go in my leaves. And I definitely want to get rid of all of my leaves. I don't want to leave them in here. I just had a large aphid outbreak. And I also don't want to dump them right outside my tunnel in a compost pile. If I have a lot of aphids or bugs, I will actually put them in a garbage bag, take them to the dumpster so we don't reinfect here. Otherwise, it's got some dead aphids on it. I'm not worried, and I'll take them out, so.
The determinate tomato variety trial here at Dixon Springs has now been in the ground, I believe, 11 weeks. And you can see our plants have definitely been growing. If you look, you can see I count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So we've put 5 strings on these plants to help support them. We have not harvested any fruit off of these plants yet, which is a little bit surprising. I would have hoped that we would have had fruit ripening by now, but what I am noticing is tremendous fruit size. And another interesting thing that I've been noticing on several of the varieties is that sometimes the second and third cluster will be the same size as the bottom first cluster. And actually, one of the things that I'm a little bit concerned about is that all of the fruit on these plants may decide to ripen within a couple of week window, and we may have a really large flush and harvest on these plants, and then maybe not have any tomatoes to harvest for a while. And the way that some of the fruit is starting to look, it's gone from the kind of limey, iridescent-y green to the more whitish green, the lighter green. And so I think we're getting pretty close to seeing fruit start to ripen. I really hope to see that next week. And hopefully not everything will ripen all at once on these plants. Give us some staggered harvests. And you can see most of these varieties are setting good fruit load. And the different clusters are sizing very, very nicely. As an example, if you look past the row right in front, kind of move in, we can see a really nice cluster of fruit on that plant. And so this is kind of the stage that we're at with these tomatoes. And if you're trying to determine about how tall they are, most of these are running at about 5 feet in height right now. Some of them are approaching the 5.5 to I won't say they're at 6 feet yet, but there's a couple of plots. This one in particular over here, you can see it's a lot taller, literally almost a foot taller or more than some of the other plots. I believe that variety is going to be either Jolene or Red Snapper. Oh, actually it's not. It's an STM2255. Very, very tall structured plant. It's taller than me at this point, and there will definitely need to be more strings put on these rows to help support the plants as they continue to grow. And they're continuing to set more flowers and more fruit, even above this top fifth string that we have so far. So we'll need to put on probably another two strings. We may top out at the top of these posts. One other thing I wanted to show you, if anybody's been watching these videos from the beginning, this very outside row that had been part of the trial planted with the same varieties, different varieties. This row of plants did not grow, and we ended up having to rip them all out, and we replaced them with Red Deuce. And you can see the replacement plants are growing phenomenally. I see no signs at all of being stunted or any signs of any disease on these whatsoever. And so really pleased with how this planting has come on. So I guess we will have about 3/4 of a row of late planted tomatoes, and we'll see what their harvest season looks like. And now we will move over and kind of take a walk down the bell pepper rows and check out the how these plots look with our spacing study. The row on the left will be single rows spaced at either 12, 18, or 24 inches. And the row on the right will be double rows that are spaced at either 12, 18, or 24 inches. We did harvest a few fruit off of these earlier in the week, maybe a half bushel total off of all of the plots. But we did have a few fruit that had sized and had matured enough to harvest. And I would say early next week we'll be coming through and harvesting again. We still have more fruit that are sizing nicely. Let's see what this looks like in here. In this particular plant, we have a smaller fruit setting up high, but behind it we have a large fruit sizing very well here. Still a little bit soft to the squeeze, so we'll leave that and wait for it to firm up before we harvest it. And we have not put a second string around these plots. We still just have the single string, and we're seeing more flowering further up the plant, so we'll be seeing more fruit sizing later through the year as well. And also just wanted to show you some of the different colors and the different cut flowers that we have out. I'm a fan of deep purple to blue flowers, and so this larkspur, I really, really think the flowers are really pretty. I love the intensity and the iridescence of some of the blue in with it. So up in the front, you might see a little bit of a theme. We have several light blue, dark blue, purplish flowers that we planted. And we'll see, this is a really pretty color, snapdragon. I believe the variety is flamingo. And I like that it's got a little bit of a corally salmon color. It's not just straight up pink. So I really like the color on that one. And down here we've got a mix of straw flowers. And then as we scan on down, we've got some different zinnias and some sunflowers at the very end.